Hi, this is Vishwanatham from Government Degree College Medak. So this video about excretory system part 2. So in the previous video discussed on the types of excretory systems and what are the products of the excretory system. So what is excretory system in the previous video, and the excretory organs. So in from the protozoans to mammalians, what are the excretory organs are present, these are also discussed, and excretory products. So mainly major excretory products in the that is formation of the nitrogen based molecules, that from that is there are three mainly number of excretory products are there. One we are called amino acids and ammonia. So ammonia is how toxic in our body, and these are the formation of ammonia into that is ammonium hydroxide, NH4OH. This is also discussed, and the urea. So in the urea, that is ornithine cycle or urea cycle or Krebs-Hanslet cycle. So the formation of the that is fumarate enter into the that is Krebs cycle. How the it is enter into the Krebs cycle, and again the arginine is formed and urea is again produced in the connect of the Krebs citric acid cycle. So this is already discussed, and arginine furans. How the uric acid is formed, this is about the uric acid. So these are the number of excretory products are there. So this we are deeply discussed in the previous video, but today we are going to discuss the structure of the excretory system and structure of the nephron in this video, right? So before that, the structure of the animals division based on the excretory products. Actually on the earth the animals are divided into three types mainly, based on the excretory products that we are called amenotelic animals, ureotelic animals, and uricotelic animals. So these are the three types of products are produced from the nitrogen based elements. So based on this three, that is divided into three types animals. One we are called amenotelic animals, ureotelic animals, and uricotelic animals. So in the amenotelic animals, so total ammonia is produced in this excretory products. That ammonia is when the water is very highly is present to these animals, then the ammonia is easily released. So that animals are protozoa, cylindrates, annelida, and crustaceans, echinodermata. In the echinodermata, that is a starfish, and fishes. The fishes about the that is teleost fishes means bone fishes, and tadpole larva. So the protozoans, cylindrates, annelida, crustaceans, echinodermates, fishes, mainly teleost fishes, and tadpole larva. So tadpole larva belongs to amphibians, means a frog. So these animals release the excretory products as a ammonia. That's why these we are called as a amenotelic animals. Actually tadpole larva is a larva of the frog, but the adult frog released urea, but the larva released ammonia. So this is basic difference in the frog development and adult in the frog development. So that's why the larva is belongs to amenotelic animals, but the amphibians are belongs to ureotelic animals. So this is second one, ureotelic animals are actually they release the urea. That is by the urea cycle, which is present in these liver cells and muscle cells. The urea is released when the water is less is present, then the urea is released. The example of the ureotelic is amphibians, cartilage fishes and mammals. So these are the very important animals belongs to ureotelic animals. Amphibians, cartilage fishes, not bone fishes, these are the cartilage fishes, and mammals, all mammals, ureotelic animals. So so not less water, there is sufficient water is present. But third one we are called uricotelic animals. Uricotelic animals. So uricotelic means the water is not available. They not take drink the water, or they are not taking the water. They are gain the water from their food only. So this we are called as a uricotelic animals. So means uric acid is released. In the ureotelic, urea is released, but in the uricotelic, uric acid is released. This uric acid is released in the insects, reptiles, and aves. So these are the main examples for the uricotelic animals. So this based on these three, amenotelic, uricotelic, and ureotelic, these three are divided the animals as a three groups. Right, amenotelic, ureotelic, and uricotelic. So this is about the animal division based on the excretory products. So the next second one in the excretory system, the mammalian excretory system. So that is we are discussed about the mammalian excretory system. So mammalian excretory system. So very resemble structures are present in all mammals. Mainly the excretory products are collected by mainly kidneys. There are two kidneys are present in the mammals. Mainly in the that is these kidneys are belongs to metanephrons kidneys. This we are called as a metanephrons. So this is we are called as a metanephrons. These are belongs to metanephrons and bean shaped. So it has a bean shape like structure like this. Already we know that there are two bean shaped structures are present. So this bean shaped kidneys are present in abdominal. So they are present in the abdominal and protected by ribs. So mainly these kidneys are protected by ribs in the dorsal side and at the region of abdominal. So these two kidneys are present in the abdominal of the dorsal side, so in abdominal, suppose the left side of the kidney is present and right side of the kidney is just slightly below the when we are compared with the left side kidney. Why? Because here the liver is present. The large size of the liver is present in our right side. So this large size of the liver, because the slightly the right side of the kidney, the right side kidney is slightly below when we are compared with left side kidney. So this is slightly difference between the position of the kidneys. And also in the adult, main adult, in the male, suppose in the male, that is 125 grams to 170 grams is present. So in the male adult, the kidneys of the weight is 125 grams to 170 grams. But in the female adult, 115 grams to 155 grams. So in the females, the weight is very less, not very less, it is slightly less compared with the male adults. So this is about the kidneys. And these are the structure of kidneys. Actually, this is the main structure is there, the excretory system of the mammals. So this is excretory system of the mammals. So these are the kidneys. So this is left side kidney and this is right side kidney. So this is right side and this is left side kidney. And every kidney is containing that is as a gland like structure, not a gland, it is an extended gland on the anterior of the kidney that we are called as a adrenal gland, the yellow part. So here and here the yellow part shows that is called adrenal glands. So means every kidney of the portion that is anterior portion is covered by as a 25%, not as a major portion, slightly it is covered by adrenal gland. And again the kidneys, so the kidneys are open by the one large tube that we are called into the kidney that we are called pelvis. So every kidney is open into the tubes like structures, the opening part we are called as a pelvis. So this hilus also we are called as a hilus, that hilus is open into the pelvis, but the pelvis is open into the hilus and then the hilus is extended as a tube like structure. The tube like structure we are called as a ureter. So this we are called as a ureter. There are two ureters are present, left side and the left side kidney that is open into the left ureter, and right side kidney is open into the right side ureter. So these are the ureters, two ureters are present and they are extended near the pelvic region. So pelvic region of the posterior side, that in the pelvic region these are open into the mainly urinary bladder, not gallbladder, it is a urinary bladder. So this sac like structure we are called as a urinary bladder. So this is urinary bladder, this one is urinary bladder. The urinary bladder open by the urethra, that is we are called urethra, and this urethra act as a release of urine, and it is also male gametes or that sperms are released by the urethra. So this is a structure, and every kidney is gain the blood through the main veins that we are called aorta, and inferior vena cava. The inferior vena cava is collect the deoxygenated blood from this by the renal vein. The inferior vena cava is collected the deoxygenated blood through the renal vein, which is nearly open into, which is closely open into the kidneys. And at the same time the aorta is open into the kidneys by the renal arteries. So the aorta is extended into the kidneys by renal artery, and the renal artery is filter the blood in the kidney structure. So this is important structures present in the excretory system, mainly two kidneys, they are bean shaped, and every kidney in the male that is 150 to 170, 115 to 170 weight is present. In the female it's 125 to 150 grams, that is kidney present, and every kidney has a bean shaped, and they are open into the hilus of the with the help of pelvis, and every kidney is covered by at the region of anterior by the adrenal glands, and every kidney is open into the ureters, and ureters are open into the by opening into the that main sac like structure that we are called urinary bladder. So in the urinary bladder of the wall, that is the main cells are present, that cells we are called as a that is main cells that we are called as a that is transitional epithelium is present. In the urinary gallbladder, transitional epithelium is present. In that epithelium, that is, sorry, by the epithelium, this is containing the, that is, muscles for the contracting and relaxation of the urinary bladder. In the urinary bladder, nearly 700 to 800 milliliter of the urine is present. The urinary bladder, that is 700 to 800 milliliters of the urine is form, and when it is increased their volume, the urethra is released that urine by the voluntary muscles. So there are two types of muscles are present in the urinary bladder, that we are called as involuntary muscles and voluntary muscles, right? So this is main important of the urinary bladder, and this is about the excretory system. So after the excretory system, that is the structure mainly in the excretory system, the major parts are kidneys. The major parts are very important. There we are called as the kidneys. So these are the shape which we are seen in the image as a shape, that we are called kidney structure, right? So in the kidney structure, mainly observe here, there are number of parts are present in kidney. So the every kidney is as a bean shape, we already discussed on that. In the kidneys, there are two main regions are present. One we are called as a cortex, and another inner part we are called as a medulla. So the outside portion we are called as a cortex. So outside portion we are called as a cortex, and inner portion we are called as a medulla. And after medulla, as a extended part is there. The medulla is extended as a large size, that we are called as a pelvis. The pelvis is open into the ureter by the hilus, that we are called hilus. So the pelvis of the medulla is extended near the cortex, means the closest parts are there in the kidneys, that is the cortex and medullas are nearly close. In the nearly close of these two portions, that is the structure is present, that as a coelom like structures are present near the between the medulla and the cortex, as a small coelom like structures present. That coelom we are called as a calyces. That coelom we are called as a calyces. So this calyces we are called actually this is the calyces. So in the calyces means one of the cavity like structures are present between the cortex and medulla. So in the calyces means in the coelom type of cavity, in that cavity the medulla is extended and form as a pyramid like structures. So these are the pyramids, the blue color parts. The blue color parts we are called as a pyramids. So these are the pyramids. So these pyramid like structures. So these pyramids are open into the near they are embedded in the calyces. So actually this is calyces. Suppose this is calyces. So in this calyces, the medulla is extended their portion as a triangle shape, that we are called pyramid. The tip of the pyramid, suppose this is base part of the pyramid, this is the tip of the or top or the pointed part of the pyramid, we are called as a that is a renal papillary. That is, we are called as a renal papillaries. So this part, this portion, we are called as a renal papillaries. Right. So this portion. So in the calluses, the pyramid of the structure of the medulla is present, and at the same time, between there are number of calluses are present. In the number of calluses, the medulla is formed as a pyramids. Means number of pyramids are there. Nearly 12 to 14 pyramids are in the nearly in the kidneys. Maybe it's a more than number is there. So in the pyramids, there are small tube-like structure, tubules-like structures are present. In the pyramids, there are small tubule-like structures are present. Suppose that we are called as a nephrons. So again, observe here. Suppose this is pyramid structure. In the pyramid, the tubule-like structures are present. So this is type. So number of tubule-like structures are present. This we are called as a nephrons. Nephrons are very important. In the that is filter of the blood to form that is the urine. Right. So this is very important. That is structurally and functionally units are present in the every pyramids. So in every every number of pyramid that is nephrons are present, right? And again between the pyramids. So observe between the pyramids. The cortex is extended into the between the pyramids near to medulla. Now this is extended is there. The black color of the extended is there here and here and here. So these are the extended of portion of the cortex. So this we are called as a Bertin columns. So this is called Bertin columns. These are called as a Bertin columns. So this Bertin columns extended portion of the cortex, and in the kidneys, from the nephrons, that is a number of nephrons are open into as a common tube. Suppose these are the nephrons, and these are the number of nephrons are present. These are the number of nephrons are open into common main tube that we are called collecting tube. So means nephrons are open into the collecting tube, and all collecting tubes, suppose this one collecting tube and another collecting tubes are open into the major tube. So nephrons are open into the collecting tubes, and collecting tubes are finally open into the major portion of the tube that we are called Bellini tube. So this Bellini tube open into the pelvis, and that pelvis are open into the hilus, and then finally it is open into the ureter. Right. So this is about the kidney, and again in the kidney structure, the major is there, that is renal arteries are extended into the kidney structure, every portion of the kidney, and at the same time the renal veins also come out from the every portion of the kidneys, and this renal vein is open into the inferior vena cava, and the renal arteries are open into the aorta. So it is open into the aorta. So these are the very important structures present in the kidney structure, and also the color of the kidneys. So the cortex has that is dark in red color, but the medulla has not dark, is a light red color is present. So dark red color belongs to cortex, and pale, or that is light red color is present in medulla. So this is the about the structure of kidney. So after the kidney, nephron structure is there. After kidney, nephron structure is there. The nephrons, now the portion, the that is main structural and functional of unit in the kidneys are nephrons. So this is called as a nephrons. So in the nephron structure, mainly two portions are there. So observe that the nephron is this is the structure of nephron. So this is the nephron structure. So in the nephron structure, there are mainly two portions are present. That we are called Malpighian corpuscles, and second one we are called uriniferous tubules. So every nephron has 3 cm length, and 2 millions of the nephrons are present in the kidneys, two kidneys. So means every kidney contain 1 million, nearly 1 million nephrons, and in the two there are 2 millions of the nephrons are present. So in the structure of the nephrons, there are two parts are there. One we are called Malpighian corpuscles, and the second one we are called uriniferous tubules. In the Malpighian corpuscles, Bowman capsule and glomerulus present. In the uriniferous tubules, there are again above the three structures are present, but here the proximal convoluted tubule, PCT, we are called as a PCT, proximal convoluted tubule, and Hens loop, and third one we are called as a distal convoluted tubules. So these are the three main portions are present in the uniferous tubules, and two main portions are present in the Malpighian corpuscles. So again, observe the structure of the nephron. This is the structure of nephron. So in the structure of nephron, that is Bowman capsule, we have discussed on that Bowman capsule and glomerulus. So this pink color we are called this portion we are called as a glomerulus, and this cup like saucer like structure, as a cup like structure, we are called as a Bowman capsules, right? So these are the two portions are present in the Malpighian corpuscles, right? And after the Bowman capsule, so this glomerulus is opened by the, or it is made by the arteries of the renal. So here the renal, so this is called renal artery. The pink color we are called as a renal artery. This renal artery is extended into the pyramids of the medulla, and then in the pyramids of the medulla, in the Malpighian, the renal artery is formed as a complex of the tubules, means complex of the, or net-like structure is formed in the between the Bowman capsule. So this is net-like structure. The pink color shows as a net-like structure. This we are called as a glomerulus. The glomerulus form with the help of renal artery. That renal artery is enter into the near the form of the net, that we are called afferent artery. And after formation of the net, it extended, means after formation of the glomerulus, it again come out from the Bowman's capsule, that we are called afferent artery. So means the renal artery enter into the Bowman capsule, that artery we are called as a afferent artery. And after in the Bowman capsule, the glomerulus come out from the Bowman capsule, the renal artery come out, means glomerulus After formation, the renal artery come out from the Bowman's capsule, that we are called efferent artery. So that efferent artery again form as a number of tubules, and that we are called as a, and it is connected with renal vein, that connected with this yellow portion, renal vein. So after formation of the efferent artery, it is extended on the second part of the nephron. On that nephron, this efferent artery again connected with renal vein and form as a, that is vasa recta. The vasa recta is a nut-like structure. This is the formation of renal artery of efferent artery. So this is the main structure in the nephrons. And again, in the nephrons, that second part we are called. So this is about the first part, that is Malpighian corpuscles. Malpighian corpuscles means Bowman capsule and glomerulus capsule, glomerulus structure. The glomerulus formed with the help of renal artery by the afferent artery, and extended, the glomerulus extended by, as a afferent. And what is the vasa recta? So this is belongs to first portion of the nephron, that we are called Malpighian corpuscles, and the second portion of the nephron. So second portion of the nephron, that we are called as a uriniferous, that we are called as a uriniferous tubules. Second portion of the nephron we are called as a uriniferous tubules. So this uriniferous tubules contain proximal convoluted tubules, proximal PCT, that we are proximal convoluted tubules. And second one, Henle loop. So this is Henle loop here. The Henle loop is present. And the Henle loop is there. The PCT, proximal convoluted tubule, is there. And this portion, so this is a distal convoluted tube. So these three structures, and collecting, it is finally open into the collecting tubule, right? The proximal convoluted tubule is extended of Bowman capsule. Actually, Bowman capsule is extended as a proximal convoluted tube. So this is the portion. Actually, this is Bowman capsule. This Bowman capsule is extended as a first portion, that we are called proximal convoluted tube, or we are called as a PCT tube. And this PCT tube again extended as a orange color. Suppose this orange color. So this orange color portion, this orange color portion, we are called as a, the second part of the that is tubule, that is uriniferous tubule, that we are called Henle loop. It is a hairpin like structure or U shaped structure. So the first part of the U shape we are called descending tubule. So this, suppose it is a Henle loop, it is a descending tubule. And the second one we are called ascending tubule. So means this is descending and this is ascending tubule. So in the Henle loop, it is a U-shaped or hairpin like structure. It contains two portions, one we are called as descending and another one we are called ascending tubules. So this ascending tubule finally form as a green color structure, that is we are called as a distal convoluted tube. So this is called DCT. So here we are called PCT, proximal, this we are called distal convoluted tube. So the distal convoluted tube is open into the collecting tube. So this is collecting tube, this portion is collecting tube. So means every nephron contain the structures, and it is finally open into the connecting tubes. This connecting tubes finally open into the Bellini tube, the major, the big structure of the that is collecting tube is present from the collecting tubes, that we are called as a Bellini tubules. These Bellini tubules are open into the pelvis, and that pelvis is open into the ureter. Right. So this is about the nephron structure. So in the nephron structure, that is the Bowman capsule is present, and the glomerulus is present, and the proximal convoluted tubule is present, and Henle loop is present, and distal convoluted and collecting tubes are present, and the glomerulus is formed with the help of artery. That artery is before the glomerulus, it act as a afferent artery, and then the glomerulus, after the glomerulus, it act as a afferent artery. Finally, afferent artery form as a net like structure on the that is proximal convoluted tube, Henle loop, on distal convoluted tube, and then it form as a net like structures with the connect of that is veins, renal veins. It's called as a vasa recta. So this about the nephron structure. This is about the nephron structure. So the nephron structure is 3 cm in length. Every nephron is a 3 cm, and there are 2 millions of the nephrons are present in the 2 kidneys. So each one kidney contain that is 1 millions, right? So from the nephrons, from the nephron structure, as a questions as there, that we are called what are the main portions are present in the nephron, means small Pigeon corpuscles and uniferous tubules. The Bowman capsules and glomerulus belongs to small Pigeon corpuscles. So distal convoluted tube is open into collecting tubes. So now these are the multiple choice questions, and Henle loop is open into distal convoluted tubes. And on the uniferous tubules, the net-like structure is present, that we are called, that is vasa recta. The vasa recta is composition of renal arteries, of the renal efferent arteries, and renal veins. What is glomerulus? Glomerulus is the filter. A filter-like structure as a net-like structure is formed in the Bowman capsules, and it is the a portion of the arteries, right? And what are the structures are present in the what are the tubules are present in the Henle loop, means descending tube and ascending tube. So this is mainly bit questions, and in the bit questions from the kidneys, what is calyces? So calyces are the cavities which are present between the cortex and medulla. And what is a Bertin column? So Bertin columns are the extended portion of the cortex between the pyramids. Pyramids are the portion of which part? Means medulla. And the point of the pyramid called as a renal papillaries or renal papillaries. So the medulla of the Bellini, the Bellini is open into the pelvis, right? And that is main portions, that is nephron, the unit and function of the function and the structural of unit of the kidneys, nephrons. So these are the external structure, that is a total structure of the excretory system, that is kidneys and adrenal gland, about ureter and urethra, and what is urinary bladder. So what is the volume is present in the urinary bladder, that is 700 to 800 milliliter of the urine is preserved in the urinary bladder, right? So these are kidneys, the weight of the kidneys, and based on the division of based on the that is excretory products, the animals are divided. How many types they are divided? Amenotelic animals, ureotelic animals, and uricotelic animals. There are three types of animals. The that is human beings are belongs to which type of division of excretory products? Means ureotelic animals. The birds, uricotelic animals. So tadpole larva is belongs to amenotelic animals, but the amphibians are belongs to uricotelic animals. So this type of that is one word questions are asked, or multiple choice questions are asked from the that is structure of kidneys. So thank you.